Thanks for checking out this No Spoilers movie review. This is for All the Colors of the Dark, which is a 1976, sorry, had to remind myself with my notes here, a 1976 film. It's an Italian film. It is in Italian. It's currently streaming on the Shudder streaming service, and it is subtitles, so just know that. I don't think there's an option for dubs, but when I watch movies that are foreign, foreign titles, I usually do subtitles because I have an issue with watching people's mouths move and the words not lining up. So that's just my thing. Anyway, so All the Colors of the Dark, it has a little bit of a giallo feel to it, which isn't too much of a surprise because when I looked into it and found out who directed it, Sergio Martino, he actually has done some giallo films and he's also done some westerns. So he was very, very involved in the 70s, and that's when you were getting a lot of those types of films coming out of Italy. So it has a little bit of that kind of giallo cinematography look to it, shot selection, things like that, which looks amazing, to be honest. Like, this film looks awesome. It looks so stylish, so classy, just great. It's very aesthetically pleasing, to be honest. I'll talk a little bit more about that later, something I kind of thought of that ties into that, but two of the films that I know are kind of known in the United States that he's done are Torso and The Case of the Scorpion's Tail, which I believe The Case of the Scorpion's Tail is a giallo film, I think. People can fact check me on that and put a comment down there, by the way. Okay, so the beginning credits are super, super boring, to be honest. It's just kind of like looking at a... This doesn't spoil anything. It's just like looking at nature. You know, it's kind of like a lake with trees and stuff like that as the names come up for the credits. Now, I know this is kind of something that used to happen, and I'm really, really glad. I found myself thinking this. I'm so glad that we're past that. I'm so glad that the way we do credits now in horror films, it's more... There's a story starting, like there's actually interesting stuff going on, and they kind of like interject the credits in there. Or sometimes they don't do credits in the beginning at all. Sometimes it's just all saved for the end. So I'm much more into that. I was watching this and I'm like, ugh, how long are these credits rolling in the beginning? It's rough. So it's immediately a pretty nuts movie. There's some crazy stuff that's going on. And it's very nightmarish. It's very creepy. And this film has, like, some obvious, like, nightmares. Like, the main character actually having nightmares. And when they're doing that type of stuff, it feels dreamlike. It feels nightmarish. It's very, very creepy. The music going with it is perfect because it is so creepy and weird and kind of scary. So I really like the way they kind of pulled those sequences off. And like I said, it kind of like starts that way immediately. So you're just hit like the sensory overload of like, what is going on here? This is nuts. And then the other thing is there's a crazy amount of nudity in this. Like so many boobs and butts. It is ridiculous. All female, by the way, because it's the 70s and they weren't really doing male nudity back then. It's more of a thing now, but back then... Yeah, so it almost like immediately feels like a little bit of like a horror porno in a sense, which, you know, if that's your thing, it's your thing. I said it's basically a porn in the beginning. It's like nightmare porn in a sense, because it is pretty nightmarish, like I was saying, with the actual nightmares that are being had. And some of that imagery, if you go to bed right after, you'd be like, oh my God. There's some interesting camera shots and angles, like I was saying. There's a lot of style to it and to the feel of the film as well, kind of like the environment. You can tell that a lot of the shots are very intentional, like the scenery and the backdrop, and it just looks amazing. It looks classy, it looks stylish, it looks really, really nice. Like, I love the look of this. I love films that look this way, and a lot of those Italian films kind of did, especially the giallos of like the 60s and 70s. They all had a very similar feel and look to them, and I love it. Things look so nice and classy in the film. So when awful stuff happens, it seems even more out of place and terrible. It's kind of this contrast that you get going on, that if everything looks so good and feels so nice and classy and sleek and awesome, and then something off happens or something terrible happens, like the contrast of those things clashing is so much more. It's way more of an impact, which I think is interesting because it contrasts, that idea contrasts with what goes on mainly in horror now, which is Everything looks grittier. It looks dirtier from the get-go. So when the horrible stuff happens, it kind of feels more like it fits. It's less of a contrast and it clashes less. And it kind of is more of like, oh, I was expecting this. Like the environment kind of already told me that this was a possibility. So that's just an interesting thing that I thought about while I was watching this, of the difference between then and how they're doing it like this versus how things are pretty much done now with horror films. It does something I don't miss in movies. Another thing other than the opening credits situation. Zooming in real fast on people's faces, specifically in this film, eyes, and with like that music that's like, nee! You know what I mean? You know what I'm talking about? Just like over the top, just like, going in on the eyes, and it's just like, okay, it's over the top, it's corny, and I guess it wasn't as much so back then, but watching it now, it's just like, woof. And the other thing is, to go along with that, because the music's nuts when they do that, the music in general in this film is very heavy-handed. It's very over the top. It really makes you feel like, okay, calm down now, let's take it back a few notches here. Because the other thing is, it's signaling way too much. As we all know, I'm sure we all know pretty much, you get auditory cues from the music of how you're supposed to be feeling with the scenes. And when they're so heavy-handed and so crazy, you're just like, it's like, stop beating me over the head. Stop. It's a little too much. Like, let's have a little bit of subtlety in here, and I can kind of like figure out how I'm supposed to feel. Just make it like a little bit lighter. Well, way lighter in this case, but it's just heavy-handed, and that kind of gets to you, in my opinion. The horror dream imagery is done really well. That's what I was talking about before with like the creepy music and everything. Is a very nice backdrop to that. Music's heavy-handed. Things the main character does at certain times don't actually seem like they fit. It doesn't seem like it's legitimately a thing that that character would do, even the way that the character was set up in the beginning of the film. So that's kind of an issue with the script writing that I have, where, you need to believe within the world that's been created that the character would do what they're gonna do. And there are a few things that the character does where you're just like, no, that doesn't make any sense. She would not do that. Would not do that. The acting, by the way, is quite good in this, in my opinion. I quite like it. If you pay attention, you start to notice a particular situation each time things start to get really crazy in it. And I think that's kind of, it's set up to make you think, what is going on here? Like, is it this or is it that type of thing? And I'm specifically being vague. Well, I'm definitely being vague because, like I said, there's no spoilers. If you want to watch this film, watch it and keep this in mind, and you'll figure it out. You'll know what I'm talking about if you really pay attention to the moments where things really start to get like out of control and crazy, like the horror moments. There's something particular that's going on. There's something in about the environment. So just keep an eye out. So another thing I'm going to be very vague about that you'll have to figure out on your own, but I'm sure a lot of people will actually get it kind of immediately. There's a movie that came out 8 years ago. Well, eight years before this movie. So once again, a reminder, this came out in 1976. So 8 years prior to this film coming out, there was another movie that was very highly revered in the horror genre that I feel like this movie borrows from a decent amount. It's some of the themes. That's all I'm going to say about that. You can figure it out on your own. I would recommend figuring that out after you watch the movie. It may even come to you on your own without, you know, thinking back to this video to check it out, but just saying. I think the last thing I have is the movie kind of ends in a weird spot. It kind of seems like it's an ending that's almost like mid-sentence. And it's like, okay, we're ending it right now? Like, this is how you wanna? Like, I thought maybe, like, tie it up at the end it like a logical ending point instead of, like, literally seems like mid-sentence. It's kind of weird. And then it's just like, credits again. It's like, I don't know. Anyway, overall, I think I enjoyed it. I think it felt kind of slow at times, too, which, you know, you got to understand, like, this was the 70s. It was kind of more more that type of filmmaking. We're just more nowadays used to things moving a lot faster, especially in horror. So you just kind of have to temper expectations. Keep in mind when you're watching these movies and things are going slower that that's just kind of how it was. So be more patient. And I have to remind myself of that, obviously, from time to time, especially with this movie. But it was like an hour and a half, and it felt like it was definitely like 2 hours or so. So that kind of sucks. But would I recommend seeing this? I think if you haven't seen it, I would definitely recommend checking it out at least once. I don't think I'd watch it more than that, to be honest. I'm not going to revisit it. But like I said, it looks really good. There's an okay story to it, but I'm sure it was a little more original back then. But nowadays, it's been done before type thing. And that's kind of the thing that sucks about watching much older films is that the story doesn't hold up as much now just because so many people have done stuff that's similar. You know, like people say there are no original ideas anymore in film. So back then there were, but now not so much. But yeah, I mean, I enjoyed it. If for anything other than the fact that it looks really good. It looks really good. The shots, the directing, it's nice. So anyway, I would recommend it, but it's not like crazy awesome. So on my scale of 5 stars with half stars in play, I'm going to give it a 3. I think it's a 3-star film. Go ahead and check it out if you haven't seen it before. And hopefully you enjoy it. And yeah, so thanks for checking this out. Please go ahead and hit the subscribe. It's the least you can do for me if you like anything that I do. I would really appreciate that. Literally takes you a second. Totally painless. Put some comments down there. Have you seen this movie? What did you think? Are you excited to see the movie if you haven't? Let me get your feedback. And then, yeah, likes if you want to do some likes. But you don't have to. I'd rather have the subscribes instead. So thank you so much for checking this out, and until next time, keep it brutal.